get him one time.
Okay, preseason practice. It's been a very interesting preseason practice because we have 9 new players, and anytime you have that many new players, there's always it's always an adjustment in terms of how much are we going to teach and how much are we going to move forward and try to prepare the team for the upcoming games that are going to be here quickly. So we've tried to find a good balance between teaching and moving forward and preparing the team. But we've had some injuries that have slowed us down as well. We've had our 3 most experienced guards. Jeremy Holloman is possibly out for the year with a red shirt. Have to have a medical red shirt. Oscar Reinfeld has been out for 4 weeks with a stress fracture and is about to have another x-ray soon to see if he comes back. And then Musa Abdul-Aleem missed 2 weeks with a high ankle sprain. So that slowed us down when you take those experienced guards out of the mix. But what it's allowed our youngest players to do is it's given them a whole lot of reps that they normally wouldn't have had those guys not been injured. So, but it's been a good preseason. We go hard in preseason. We do 2-a-days a lot, so it becomes a grind. And now I think all the players are seeing that light at the end of the tunnel when they actually get to play against someone else. Well, our exhibition opener, our only exhibition game, we had a closed scrimmage last week, but we have a exhibition game tomorrow night against West Florida. And what we wanted to do with that exhibition game, we wanted to play somebody rather close, you know, and West Florida obviously meets that criteria, but we wanted to play somebody that come in here and really give us a good game. And West Florida, they're going to bring a team in here that's going to give us all we can handle. They've got about 4 of their top 6 players back, including their second leading scorer. They added 2 Division I transfers, a kid that played a lot for Indiana State last year, a 6'8 kid, and then a 6'6 guard who started 74 out of his 90 games at East Carolina. So those are two kids coming from really good level conferences coming in here as seniors, and they kind of get it that this is their one time to make their mark against a Division I team. And they're going to come in here really ready to play. And our team will prepare them just like a normal game. But it'll be really interesting to see how we handle it because, again, we have so many new guys. It's our first time under the lights in Trojan Arena. And I'll look for it to be a close game because I think they've got that kind of ability. And that's what we need. We need the one thing that we need to really get going here at Troy that we didn't have last year and that we've got to change it is we need to bring back the atmosphere that we used to have, you know, when I was an assistant coach for Coach Drizel at Georgia State. And we would come over here and play Troy, and Coach Maestri always had really good teams. We knew when you came over here to play Troy, it was always going to be a great atmosphere. The students were going to be at the game. It was going to be a tough place to play. And as an athlete and a coach, you like playing in those type of atmospheres. So I remember when I was at Georgia State, we always really liked to come into Troy to play. When you played at Sartain Hall, it was going to be a great atmosphere, and you better be playing your A game to win at Troy. And we didn't have that in here last year. And I know the first ingredient is winning. We got to have a winning team, and we want to have a winning team, and we want to do it with high character guys, and we want to do it in a class way, and we want to do it with effort, and we want to have the right attitude, and we want to be a team all about the team, and we want to be a selfless team that always makes the extra pass and always plays for each other. And so we know we totally get our part of what we need to do that. But then what we need to do, we need to get the fans back. And I know we've got a lot more seats in Trojan Arena than we did in Sartain Hall, but we need to get the students back involved. We need to get the community back involved. And we've got to create a home atmosphere like we used to have here at Sartain Hall. All those years when Coach Maestri had such great teams, they were consistently winning. And because the potential is there. And anytime in any league, I don't care what sports you're in any league you're in, if you're going to win in the league, you've got to win at home. You've got to protect home, and then you've got to go on the road and steal some games on the road. And it's always tough to win at home if you don't have a little advantage. And I think that's the one thing, if you could ask me, Coach, what's one thing that you could automatically have, you know, it would be let's get that atmosphere back and give his team some help in winning at home, because our plan is to try, we want to annually be competing for the Sun Belt Conference title, and we need to have a home court advantage. With our team this year, we only have 7 years of total Division I experience, and that's 1 year from Oscar, 1 year from Kevin, 1 year from Kelton Ford, 2 years from John Walton, and 2 years from Musa Abdul-Aleem. Now, in contrast, we play Ole Miss on November 17th, and they're starting backcourt, Summers and White. Those two guys have 6 years Division I experience between them. So it could be an interesting non-conference slate here, but we're really happy about our talent level, our athleticism. There's no cure for experience other than games. So we've got to get some games under our belt and pick that up. But those guys, we do have a good balance on our roster. We have, because three of those guys, the new guys, are junior college transfers. We have four freshmen, three junior college transfers, and then we added Musa from South Florida, who's a fifth-year senior and has immediate eligibility. He graduated and he's working on his master's here at Troy. But his experience was really critical in a recruiting standpoint. We knew coming into this season, losing six seniors the previous years, we knew how important it was to get somebody in here this summer who had some experience. And that's why when we found out Musa was available, we dove right in there recruiting, and he was from Atlanta, so it worked out great. And he provides a couple things: experience, and with his experience comes a physical, mature body. But he really provides outside shooting that our team needed, that our roster needed, that we didn't have at the end of the season last year. And then Kevin Thomas is another guy. He only has 1 year Division I experience, but he was a two-year starter in a really quality junior college program. He's a really mature young man. And those two guys, from an experience standpoint, coupled with, you know, throw John Walton in there with him, and John's a fourth-year junior who played 2 years at East Tennessee State, was in a really good program where he was coached well every day in practice. And those three guys we're going to lean on heavily, from giving the rest of the roster, giving those guys an experienced hand out there. Well, as noted earlier, we have a total of six freshmen. Aaron Arreary did get here last year at the semester break, so he had a semester of practice last year. But I'm gonna throw Aaron in there. Out of those six freshmen, they've all done well, and again, they've got some extra reps in here on the floor that they might not have had those guys not been injured. But those guys have done well. They've been hungry. They've been here early for practice every day and stayed late. They've had an attitude. Their collective attitude has been tremendous. Attitude has been there. Their effort level's been there. Their toughness level's been there. We've had a lot of injuries, but none of the freshmen have been injured any. I can't remember one day. I'll take that back. Damian had a concussion, and with all the new concussion protocol, he had to miss 7 days automatically. But outside that, those guys, they've been terrific. Christian Harrison, Wesley Person, I've already mentioned Aaron, Damian Ottman, Jordan Anderson, Colin Edwards. Those guys they've hung in there and gone at it every day, and I think because they've gone so hard, the whole process has been expedited because they hadn't missed with any injuries. They've been out there so many reps. So obviously, when you have a team, some guys will be more ready to play. Some guys, one freshman has really stood out, and I think everyone expected it. Wesley Person has really been good. If we start tonight, he's in the starting lineup. Obviously, he's a great shooter. It's in his blood, but he has a great basketball IQ. He's the most striking thing about Wesley, and we call him Tat. That's his nickname, Tat. But the most striking thing about him has been the maturity level he's shown. I mean, he has a one little example I'll give you. He comes into practice every day, and he has a pre-practice routine that I don't think anybody else on the team has one. And that just shows maturity for a high school, you know, kid coming right out of high school to come in here as a freshman. He knows what he's doing every day as he prepares for practice. He does the same thing every day. And all our freshmen have been like that, but he's been the one who has really performed at a high level and is a little more prepared to play early on. And he's been thrust into a huge role early, particularly with all these veteran guards we have out. You look at Jeremy Holloman and Oscar. Hadn't even practiced yet. Oscar practiced for 1 week before he went out, and Jeremy hadn't practiced at all. So that, again, that has thrust Wesley into a bigger role, But what he's shown us is he's just screamed every day, "I'm ready for that role," which has been terrific. And I think he's going to be one of the better freshmen, not only in our conference. I think he has a chance to be one of the better freshmen in the country. Now,